So one thing I wanted to talk to you about, I did a previous show with Kent Hovind. I'm sure you know who he is. He goes by the name Dr. Dino. And we had a section on morality, and I basically challenged him because he claims to have four PhDs. He says three of them are earned, one of them is an honorary degree, and he actually, even though he claims to have these four doctorate degrees, he will not name the other schools, but he does name one of them, Pacific University, which I think is strange to claim that you have doctorate degrees, but then I really pushed him, and he would not give the name of the school. I thought that was interesting. But you know, you've got a real PhD, and so I think there's a real honesty issue here. In fact, I think maybe first he got one, and then he just got used to it and got another one because people didn't challenge him on or whatever. But here's some points I want to bring up about it. Okay, so like I said, he claims three doctorates and one honorary, but he doesn't publicly name what the schools are, except for Pacific or the Patriot University. And then when you question him about it, he goes, well, it's not important to him that they're not accredited schools. But actually, the Patriot University is accredited, and it's a known fraudulent accrediting agency called ACI. There's actually a story on the internet about how they got busted for being a sham accredited agency. It's kind of a humorous story. And then he also says that Patriot University is not accredited because, of course, it's not accredited. They don't believe evolution. You know, you got to believe all this stuff in order to be accredited. But, you know, I'd point out that Baylor University, for example, is a Christian university. They're accredited. I got a seminary degree from Luther Rice Seminary in Georgia. It's a conservative Baptist. They don't believe in evolution, and they have accreditation. It's not first-tier accreditation from my school, but at least it's accredited by a decent accrediting agency. His school also has zero teaching faculty, zero. And, you know, basically it's like just a manufactured home. You could actually look at it on Google Maps. It's just a manufactured home. It's just, that's all it is. And it's a so-called university. To get the Doctor of Ministry on the website there, it says you take 12 courses, which are 36 credits plus a dissertation, 9 credits. It's 45 credits total. I think I saw somewhere else online, because I was interested in getting a PhD. I looked around. I think it was like 120 credits. And then they cost $21.89, basically $2,200 for a PhD there. And like I said, I looked into getting a PhD. They normally cost about if I wanted to get a PhD in education, it would cost about $50,000. And I noticed there's actually one where I can get a PhD in something else for about $15,000 that was accredited. So, I mean, his is only $2,000 barely. So what is your take on this? I mean, do you think this is kind of a sinful thing to do or a dishonest thing to do?
Yeah, well, you know, I'm deeply troubled when Christians, you know, misportray themselves as being experts when in fact they're not. And I mean, to be clear, there are many Christian scholars who have worked very hard to earn their degrees. You know, there are many people with, you know, PhDs and THDs and DMens, you know, that degrees that have worked very hard, as you mentioned, through schools that have been accredited, where these are rigorous degrees, and there are, you know, real, expertise that they're expected to develop. There's a lot of Christians in science who do have bona fide degrees, you know, and so, you know, to me, it's an insult to men and women who have really run the gauntlet and earned those degrees to portray yourself as something that you're not. And so, yeah, I'm deeply troubled by people that portray themselves in that way. I don't understand, you know, why they would do that or, you know, how they could justify doing something like that.
But if you're in a debate with him, Would you not bring this up, like it's a below the belt kind of hitting or something like that?
Yeah, that's a good question. If I would bring it up or not, and the reason I would say that is not because, again,
I mean, especially if you phrase it like, hey, okay, you know, Fuzz, you got a PhD in microbiology, I got a PhD in Christian education, and let me tell you, blah blah blah, you know.
I might bring it up at that point. But, you know, to me, I think that, I mean, and this is just my style and my approach, is I would prefer to try to do the best job I could to make a case for my position, where I would, you know, bring out evidence, and I would not expect you to accept my position based on just simply the authority that is undergirded by my degree, but rather I would expect you to accept my position because I've presented evidence and have made an argument that, you know, hopefully is a sound argument that's compelling. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm okay also, too, with critiquing another person's ideas and argument, you know, and try to point out places where I see problems. But, I don't know that I would go after a person's qualifications because, you know, even though Ken Hovind, I think, has a, you know, frankly, a bogus degree, it doesn't mean that he can't make valid points or present valid arguments. And mm-hmm. So that's what I would choose to focus on.
What about the appearance of, like, he did a debate with Hugh Ross, and I don't know if he had his Ph.D. back then, but, I think it comes up sometimes. I think he might even just, like, name drop it down where they'll say, like, you know, maybe they'll put on subtitles, like, you know, here's Hugh Ross, Ph.D., and then or Dr. Ross, and they might say, you know, and he might say, like, well, call me doctor, too. I'm a doctor.
Yeah. Well, you know, again, you know, I find that to be problematic. And, you know, I think it's, you know, for somebody who is, you know, producing a television program to not, it's one thing to have Kent Hovind on the program. He's a well-known public figure, you know, in this, you know, in young earth creationism. So I think it's legitimate to bring him onto a program because mm-hmm. of his prominence. But I think it's probably not the most responsible thing to actually communicate that he has a bona fide degree when in fact he doesn't.
You said
subtitles or what have you.
And you said, well, you know, people with real PhDs, you know, they work really hard for those. And he says, hey, I worked hard for mine too. You know, my first book was my dissertation. But, you know, it's kind of a joke if you look online about his dissertation. Actually, I don't know. Like, for example, you wrote a dissertation for your PhD, right?
I sure did.
Now, is that publicly available that anybody can read it, or how does that work?
I don't know how easy it is to get a copy of somebody's PhD, but I think there is actually a service that archives all PhDs. That if you go through some kind of procedure, you can actually get the copy of the PhD.
Have you ever seen Kent Hovind's PhD by any chance?
No,
his dissertation. I mean, if you ask him about it, he'll say, well, I don't know where it is. It got lost or something. I think it was actually on WikiLeaks or something. They actually have it in, supposedly, it's incomplete. And they'll say, well, he added to it later. And it's like, that's not, when you write a PhD dissertation, you don't add to it later. I mean, it's got to be complete, you know. And
yep.
And actually, when you read it, it's, you know, it's obviously not PhD level. It's like high school level, the way it's kind of written.
Yeah, well, you know, with my experience getting a PhD, it's only your dissertation is only partially meeting the requirements to earn the PhD. There's other things that you have to do as well that you have to accomplish, you know, to have the complete fulfillment of the requirements for the degree. So the dissertation is partial, but that a dissertation actually has to be evaluated by a committee of experts, and typically you bring in somebody at a university from another department to make sure that the department granting the degree is not doing something, you know, beneath the line.
Yeah.
And a lot of times people will bring in individuals who are experts outside of the university. Hmm. So I've sat on PhD committees where I was the outside person coming in. So my job was not only to evaluate the PhD, but in a sense to be a kind of a monitor to make sure that the university was actually going through a legitimate process to grant the degree. So, there's actually a committee of people that vote to determine whether or not your dissertation fulfills requirements. And again, it's people that are experts in those areas, people that are part of that particular department, people outside that department, people outside that university. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when you've completed a PhD, you really have run the gauntlet where you have people, going through the work with a fine-tooth comb, but then when it's done, it's done. Now, you could continue research in the area that you wrote your dissertation on, you know, but again, there's ways you communicate that research so that, again, people have confidence that the work that you're presenting has credibility. So that's why peer review is so important. I mean, even, you know, at Reasons to Believe, when we publish a book, we actually do our very best to have people review the manuscript would be friendly to our position, and also people that would be hostile to the position. So, right. For example, the update to Who Was Adam, we had two people from BioLogos review the manuscript, and they offered, you know, critical comments that we took seriously. You know, it doesn't mean that, you know, that the BioLogos people would agree with the contents of Who Was Adam.
Right.
But we did go out and solicit, you know, their input, and took it seriously as we shaped the manuscript.
And you said, so you basically said there'd be some outsiders coming in to look at it too, just to make sure that the department's on track at the university. Yes. But, you know, in this case, they have zero faculty also. So it's like, what does that say? I mean, they don't even have a department, it sounds like.
Yeah, well, I don't understand how you could grant somebody a PhD without there being at least a faculty advisor. Because, again, the idea is you have a faculty advisor who has a degree and who has experience in that particular field, who is guiding your research and is in effect teaching you through a process of being an apprentice how to function as a scholar in that area, you know, and then of course when you're doing your defense, it's not only you that's on trial, but it's also your PhD advisor.
What do you think about too? I mean, you said, there's a lot of hard work to get a PhD, and he says, well, I did work hard. I wrote, you know, my book reflects that. I worked hard for it. I just didn't pay money and got a degree. I worked hard. So, I mean, yeah, he did some work, but there's a huge difference between doing a lot of work and doing PhD level work, right?
Right. Yeah. I mean, but it's, you're doing hard work to get a PhD, and again, he very well could have worked hard as well, but that hard work is also in the context of, again, where there's certain criteria that you have to achieve. So it's not just simply working hard, but it's working hard to make sure you're attaining a particular standard and maintaining, you know, the quality of your work at that standard or even higher than that standard.
Okay.
You know, and the only way you can do that is within a community of people who are scholars, you know, who are holding one another accountable as well.
Okay. Anything else you want to say about that before we move on to our next topic?
Nothing other than, it's something that I think deeply saddens me that, there are a handful of Christians that portray themselves as experts when in fact they're not.
Well, I did a little bit of look on the internet too, and it seems like there is a little bit of a faction. There are some like Christian. I think there's Christian celebrities on TV. Some of the charismatic ones. They say, you know, like I don't know if it's Dr. Price or not, but there's Dr. So and so, Dr. So and so. I mean, some of these charismatic leaders just they call themselves Doctor, and they don't really have real doctor's degrees, but they just get into this, I don't know, some kind of group think where they can get away with that, I guess. Okay, so the next question I want to talk to you about